Now we are seeing some of the previous gate questions from the subject strength of materials. A torque of 10 Newton meter is transmitted through a stepped shaft as shown in the figure. The torsional stiffness of individual sections of lengths MN, NO and OP are 20 Newton meter per radian, 30 Newton meter per radian and 60 Newton meter per radian respectively. The angular deflection between the ends M and P of the shaft is, so here is a stepped shaft is given. To this shaft, a torque of 10 Newton meter is applied at the ends, and so here the individual stiffnesses for this shafts is given, stepped shaft is given MN, NO, OP. And here we have to find out the angular deflection theta in between M and P ends. And here some of the options are given. And here the correct option is option B, 1 radian. So we know stiffness or torsional stiffness is given by K is equals, if you assume K is torsional stiffness, it is K is equals to T by theta, where T is the torque applied, theta is the total angular deflection. So from this you can write theta is equals to T by K. So we know in this case total angular deflection of the total shaft is nothing but angular deflection in individual portions MN, NO, OP. So here if you write like this, so theta T by K and T is constant here, so you can write T by K MN, T by K NO, T by K OP, and for these values MN, NO, OP is given 20, 30 and 60. So when you substitute in the place of T, 10, 10, 10 in every part, and the corresponding stiffness values, and when you simplify that, we are getting the total value of theta angular deformation or deflection as 1 radian. So option B is the right option for this question. And if you see the next question, a solid circular shaft of 60 mm diameter transmits a torque of 1600 Newton meter. The value of maximum shear stress developed is, some of the options are given here, 37.72 option A, option B 47.72, option C 57.72, option D 67.72, and here the correct option is option A, 37.72. So you're asking to find out the maximum value of shear stress for the diameter of 60 mm and for which 1600 Newton meter torque is applied. So we know torque transmitted by a shaft, so if nothing is given means it's solid shaft only. So the torque transmitted by a solid shaft is given by the equation pi by 16 tau d cube, and tau represents the maximum shear stress here. So if you write, if you rearrange the terms here, tau is equals to 16 t by pi d cube, and t value is given, torque 1600 Newton meter is given. So when you convert meter to mm, so into 10 to the power of 3 meter to mm, and d value given 60 mm. So when you simplify that, we are getting the maximum shear stress. So tau means here maximum shear stress only, unless otherwise specified. So here the answer is 37.72. So option A is the right option. And if you see the next question here, two shafts AB and BC of equal length and diameters D and 2D are made up of same material. They are joined at B through a shaft coupling, while the ends A and C are built in. A twisting moment T is applied to the coupling. If TA and TC represents the twisting moments at the ends A and C respectively, and in that case is asking to find out the relation between torque developed in AB and BC. So sorry, it is given that TA is a twisting moment at end A and TC is a twisting moment at end C. So in the option we have to select a appropriate relation between TA and TC. So here for this case, when the two shafts are joined at the center, and when other ends are built in or cantilevered, when a torque is applied at the center, the angular deflection in those two shafts will be same. So we can write theta in AB is equal to theta in BC. So we know theta angular deflection, we can write TL by GJ. So from that, if you write for AB, it is TA, and AB and BC length is same, L and L. So directly we are writing in the place of L of AB, directly L. So once again, TL by GJ, we are writing TA. L by G is same, both are made up of same materials is given. So we can write G and G for both shafts. And suppose for the first shaft, it is given D is the diameter. So in the place of J, J for solid shaft, we know it is pi by 32 D power 4. So we have assumed, or it is given D is the diameter. So the same thing you can write here, pi by 32 D power 4 in the place of J for AB. And for the theta BC, TC is the twisting moment at the end C, and L is the length for BC. And G is same thing here, made up of same materials. And pi by 32 in the place of D, you have to write 2D because same material, and here the diameter is 2 times of D. So in the place of D, you have to 2D and work 4 as it is. And when you just simplify this equation, and you are getting the relation between TC and TA as TC is 16 times of TA. So option C is the right option for this question. And if you see the next question, a solid shaft of diameter D and length L is fixed at both ends. A torque T naught is applied at a distance of L by 4 from the left end, as shown in the figure given below. The maximum shear stress in the shaft is, so here is a shaft which is fixed at both the ends, and a torque of T naught is applied at the distance of L by 4 from the left side. So in this case, we have to find out the expression for maximum shear stress in the shaft. So here the correct option is option B, 12 T naught by pi d q. So see here, for this case, the maximum twisting moment developed in the shaft is given by the formula T naught is applied. So T naught into this distance, if it is applied here, so we have to write this distance 3L by 4 by L. So you simplify that, we are getting it is 3 T naught by 4. So it is a maximum twisting moment developed in this shaft. And here we require maximum shear stress developed in the shaft, tau max. So you can write it as T max by ZP. So tau max is nothing but, or tau is nothing but T by ZP you can write. So T, tau max is T max by ZP, where ZP is the polar section modulus. For solid circular shaft, its value is pi by 16 D cube. D is the diameter of the shaft. And T max we got here 3 T naught by 4. So when you just simplify that, we are getting tau max, the maximum shear stress in the shaft, as 12 T naught by pi D cube. So here the option B is the right option. And if you see the next question, a torque T is applied at the free end of stepped rod of circular cross sections as shown in the figure. So torque T is applied for these two, or for a stepped rod having two steps, and this length of first rod is L and diameter is 2D, and the second rod diameter is D and length is L by 2. So, and the shear modulus of the material of the rod is G. So only one value is given, means so the stepped rod means only one value in general. So the modulus of rigidity will be same. So that is G is given. And so here we have to find out the expression for D to produce an angular twist of theta at the free end. So we have to find out the expression for diameter of here expression for D to produce theta at free end. This theta is a angular deflection or angular twist. And here some of the options are given, and the correct option is option B. This is the right option. And see, for this case, for a stepped rod, it's at one end. So we can write some of the angular deflections in two portions is nothing but total angular deflection theta. So we can write theta is equals to theta 1 plus theta 2. So if you take this, suppose this is 1 and 2 and theta 1, so we have just seen theta, we can write TL by GJ, and in the place of, if you write theta 1, T is the torque applied, so for both torque is same. So you can write T, and length for first is L, and so we can write L here, and G and J for solid shaft is pi by 32 d power 4. In the place of d, we have to write it is 2d because its diameter is 2d given. So 2d power 4, and for the second one, t is same, and in the place of L, L by 2, it is given L by 2 length, and g into diameter is given d only. So we can write as g into pi by 32 d 4 as it is, and when you simplify that, in the next step we are getting it is TL by g pi into g into d power 4, and that is common. We are taking t l g pi d power 4 common we are taking. So in the first step we will remaining with 32 by 16, that is 2 power 4 is 16, and in the second step we are remaining with 32 by 2. So when you simplify that, so that will be, this is 2 plus 16, 18 TL by pi g d power 4, and if you write the expression for d, it is 4th root of 18 TL by pi theta g, or it is 18 TL by pi theta g whole to the power of 1 by 4. So option B is the right option here. And if you see the next question, a solid circular shaft needs to be designed to transmit a torque of 50 Newton meter if the allowable shear stress of the material is 140 megapascal. Assuming a factor of safety of 2, the minimum allowable design diameter in mm is, some of the options are given, and here the correct option is option B, 16 mm. So here allowable shear stress for shaft material is given 140 megapascal, and also factor of safety is also given. So from that we can write tau design stress, design shear stress, as allowable shear stress by factor of safety. So why? Because we know factor of safety is maximum stress or allowable stress by design stress. From that we can write design stress is equals to allowable stress by factor of safety. So here the stress is nothing but shear stress. So allowable shear stress given 140 megapascal, factor of safety is given 2. So the design shear stress will be 70 megapascal. And we know the expression for torque for a solid circular shaft, pi by 16 tau d cube. If factor of safety is not given, we can take directly the given value of 140 megapascal. So factor of safety is given. So we have to take that factor of safety into consideration. We have to use the design shear stress only. So why? Because factor of safety given means we have to consider the design stress in the design calculations. So why? Because by using this relation we are finding out the diameter, safe diameter value. So we have to take design stress. So anyway, the T value is given 50 Newton meter, converting into Newton mm, 50 into 10 to the power of 3. Maybe 16 tau design is 70 megapascal or 70 Newton per mm square, and the D we have to find out from this equation. So when you simplify that, we are getting the D value as 16 mm. So option B is the right option for this question. And if you see the next question, a hollow shaft of 1 meter length is designed to transmit a power of 30 kilonewtons at 700 rpm. The maximum permissible angle of twist in the shaft is 1 degree. The inner diameter of the shaft is 0.7 times of outer diameter. The modulus of rigidity is 80 gigapascal. Outside diameter of the shaft in mm is, so here if you see the answer is 44.5 mm or 45. Anyway, so length is given 1 meter or it is 1000 mm. Power is given 30 kilowatts or 30 into 10 to the power of 3 watts. RPM is given 700. Theta is given 1 degree. So when you convert into radians, it is will multiply with pi by 180, and the value is 0.0174. radians, and the ratio between inside to outside diameter of the shaft is given, so that we are taking it as small k, and it is 0.7 given, and modulus of rigidity g is given 80 gigapascal, or it is 80 to 10 to the power of 3 megapascal, and we have to find out the outside diameter of the hollow shaft. So to find out how outside diameter, we'll use this relation, that is j is equals to TL by g theta. So we know, we will write j for hollow shaft, we know expression, standard expression, we'll write pi by 32 d naught power 4 by 1 minus k power 4. So for that we require torque, so we'll find out torque from the power formula. We know power is equals to p is equals to 2 pi n t by 60. From that, if you write t, 60 p by 2 pi n, 60 into p value is 30 into 10 to the power of 3 watts, 2 into pi into n value 700. So when you simplify that, we are getting t as torque as 409.2 newton meter, or it is 409.2 into 10 to the power of 3 newton mm. So next, from the relation t by j is equals to g theta by l, we can write the expression for j as tl by g theta. And here the hollow shaft, so we have to write j for hollow shaft. So we know j for hollow shaft, it is pi by 32 d naught power 4 into 1 minus k power 4, where k is ratio between inside to outside diameters, and d naught is outside diameter. So when you simplify, substitute the value of torque we got in the previous step, 409.2 into 10 to the power of 3, length 1000 mm, g 80 into 10 to the power of 3 megapascal, and a theta 0.0174 radians, and k value is 0.7 given. So when you just substitute and simplify that, you are getting outside diameter as 44.55 mm, or you can take 45 mm. And next, if you see the next question, a cantilever type of gate hinged at Q, this place shown in the figure, P and R are the centers of gravity of the cantilever part and counterweight part respectively. So it is a gate structure is given, and is having a shape of cantilever beam, and R is a counterweight, and this is the gate portion, and here P is the center of gravity of this gate portion and our cantilever portion, and R is the center of gravity of counterweight portion. So these two are hinged at suppose Q, it is the gate is hinged at Q, and here the mass of this cantilever part means up to this part is given 75 kg, the mass of the counterweight for static balance. So the mass of counterweight we have to find out for this portion, mass we have to find out for keep this the gate in equilibrium or static balance. And some of the options are given here, and if you see, the correct option is option D, 300 kg. So we know to keep this in equilibrium, or to keep this gate in balanced, gate in balance, so we know some of the moments about any point must be zero, or moment we are taking moments about Q equating to zero to keep this in balance. So we know about Q, P will produce clockwise moment because the weight will act downwards, and about the same point Q, R will produce anti-clockwise moment. So sum of clockwise and anti-clockwise moments about Q must be zero. So that's why we are taking here this portion. Center of gravity is this, and center of mass or gravity, the weight will or mass will goes to this point. So the mass is given 75 kg, and so we know moment is force, or here instead of force we are taking the mass. So mass into distance, 75 into 2, so clockwise and anti-clockwise minus, and here this is if you assume x as a weight or mass. So x into distance is 0.5. When you simplify that, we are getting the x value as 300 kg. So option D is the right option here. And if you see the next question, cantilever beam of length L is subjected to a moment M at free end. The moment of inertia of beam cross section about the neutral axis is I, and Young's modulus is E. The magnitude of maximum deflection is, And some of the options are given, and here the right option is option A, that is ML square by 2EI. So we know this is a standard formula, standard case we have to remember, that is maximum deflection of cantilever beam subjected to movement at free end. So the deflection Y max is nothing but when it is the cantilever beam is subjected to movement at free end. So the maximum deflection is given by the equation or relation ML square by 2EI. So here the option A is the right option for this question. So for more videos, please subscribe and activate bell symbol, and also please share my videos with your friends. Thanks for watching.